first home defeat of the season last week, a 3-1 loss to Adelaide City. Coach Bertie Mariani makes two changes. David Lowe's out through suspension and Steve Georgiakis moves to the bench. Coming in, Jean-Paul Demarini and Peter Katholis. South Melbourne suffered a 3-2 loss at St George last weekend. Ferenc Puskas has made four changes. Coming back from suspension is captain Angelo Postecoglou. Kim Taliadoras comes back after injury. And Danny Wright and Joe Palacides get a recall. Our referee this evening is Gary Powell from Sydney, as Marconi get us underway attacking the goal to our right in the first half. Be interesting to see tonight how Marconi line up. Already it seems that Robbie Wheatley this week has gone to sweeper, with Mark Jones dropping into right back. And Paul O'Connor again pushed into midfield, this time though with Ian Gray also there. Marconi, who have had an impressive run at home this season, came down to earth with a thud last weekend. Good long ball forward, picks out Ian Gray. Sills made a run to the near post. Eased away though by Durakovic. Here's Mickey Peterson. South Melbourne come into this game with a good record here at the Marconi Stadium. Haven't been beaten here since Marconi won in 1982. They've drawn four of their last five visits. The dynamo in midfield for South Melbourne. These two teams met earlier this season in round 13. Marconi run out winners 3-0 in Melbourne. It ended South Melbourne's 26-game unbeaten home run. Jean-Paul Demarini. It's luck there from a long way out. Scored at all this season. His last goals, in fact, were two against Arpia Leichhardt last season. Now right. See these, Trimboli, caught from behind by McCulloch. Challenge there. Paul Trimboli limps away. Peterson. This is Kim Taliadoras. South Melbourne get the first corner of the evening. Kim Taliadoras, who missed last week's game through injury, or in fact was coming back from injury, had a run in the youth side and scored. It's convinced Ferenc Puskas. He's now fully fit. Blair, he goes forward for corners. Get the header that time anywhere near the target. No worries at all for Wheatley, who can bring it forward and then tries to release Katholis. Durakovic got there first. Good tidying up from Mehmet Durakovic. Katholis. Now Gray. Good run from Ocon. He was well picked out by Gray. Ocon playing it in early. Here's Seal. Keeper got there first. It's McLaren there, very much alert. But Paul Ocon had pulled away and had a clear run to goal. He was well spotted initially by Ian Gray. A dangerous ball this into the near post. The keeper got there just before Seal. Alcides. Cauldron. Rescuing it up there for Marconi. Nice encounter between these two sides, entertaining affairs. Fellas. Here's Steele. Steele's got it past the keeper. And Marconi take the lead. The goal come in after 6 minutes. And David Seal gets it past Bruce McLaren. What a ball this from Peter Katholis from the halfway line. played it inside the defender, and Seal was awake to the situation, and that's good finishing. But Peter Gatholis, who's been in splendid form this season, certainly there has justified his recall. And David Seal, who hasn't scored in the last four games, opens the scoring here after 6 minutes with his 16th goal of the season. Marconi Fairfield 1, South Melbourne 0. What a start for David Seal. He's waiting, hitting this one deep. England got there before Blair. Ocon. Some call under pressure. Follows his first touch, letting him down. Here comes Peterson. Pushing the back there from Nicky Peterson. Ocon, who plays sweeper for the Australian U side, pushed into midfield last week. He's got another run in that position this week as well. But here he gets a push in the back from Nicky Peterson for his trouble. He needs to chase. All depending now on the bounce for him. He's faced by Wheatley. Needs help at the moment. Wheatley there, judged to have been doing some pushing in the back. Joe Palacides there, needed help, and there was nobody forward with him for South Melbourne. Bobby Catlin ensuring that that far post is completely covered by the four-man wall. Salakis will fancy his chances from this range. It's been a lean season so far for Salakis. He's only scored 3 goals. He's got that past the wall, and in the end, too hot to handle for Bobby Catlin. And so close there to goal number 4 for Peter Salakis. He's now got to face this corner. Blair again was forward. Yasalakis. Putting that one in. Blair going for it. Away though by Cauldron. Tholis. And now Gray. Only coming out quickly. But nobody got that far forward for them. Danny Wright. Triboli. Here comes Taliadoros. Cauldron got there first. Taliadoros judged to have fouled Steve Cauldron as he went through. Ocon. One of those runs of his, which he does so well, he just goes past players as if they weren't there. Catholis! Tips over in the end by the keeper. Fell to Peter Catholis's trusted left foot. But Paul Ocon started this run on the edge of his own penalty area. He went past players as if they weren't there and releases it perfectly to Catholis, took it in his stride. And it's Wade. Now Postecoglou. There's the number 3 shirt, but he loves attacking down this left-hand side. This time, though, cutting infield, here's Trimboli. Lovely turn from Trimboli. Brilliant goal. Paul Trimboli. A goal of magic. Catlin is beaten. He was given no chance with that whatsoever. The switch in play from Nicky Peterson. Picked out Postecoglou. The way ahead of him was completely open, but he cut infield. Got it through to Trimboli. Good turn that. Good skill. Deadly finishing. Brilliant goal from Trimboli. And Catlin given no chance whatsoever. But Paul Trimboli got away from his marker for the first time, and that's the result. And 38 minutes gone. It's 1-1 here at the Marconi Stadium. Trimboli, 7 goals now for the season. He won't score many better than that. Gross letting the ball run. Return for Gefolis. And in the dive in the end, says referee Gary Power. Play continues, South Melbourne in possession. Peterson, this time Palisides is offside by a couple of yards. Seal this time offside, it won't count. Eric Cohen, the linesman on this near touchline. Bruce McLaren would have been very happy to see that flag raised. David Seal wouldn't. Ball pushed through, and Seal a couple of yards offside, although he still finishes it. Now Wade. Whiter made a late run. Wade picks him out well. Now Taliadoros as the half-time whistle goes. The first half that saw the scoring open after 6 minutes from David Seal. Goal number 16 of the season. But a goal after 37 minutes of cheer class from Paul Trimboli gives us a half-time scoreline here at the Marconi Stadium. Marconi Fairfield 1, South Melbourne 1. So no changes in either side as South Melbourne get the second half underway. Muir White now attacking the goal to our right. Run across there first for Marconi. Started off the first half. The style would seem to lose their way as the first half progressed. A lot of long balls played through the centre. They look so much better when they build up their attacks and use the full width of the field as they did early in the first half. Trimboli brought South Melbourne back onto level terms after 37 minutes. Wheatley. Over there from Seal. It's Gefolis. Out by Peterson. It's McCulloch. Here's Seal. That one stung the goalkeeper's fingers, but he kept it out. David Seal, who's looked so sharp in front of goal tonight. Scored after 6 minutes, he had one disallowed for offside. His policy is... it's a shot wide. He was put under pressure there from Robbie Wheatley. And the defender did enough. It was even closer at the other end with David Seal. Jones has gone forward. He links up well with McCulloch and Seal hit it first time and that was travelling. Is Palisides, and here comes Taliadoros, awkward angle. Palisides waits at the far post, and it's charged down though by Jean-Paul De Marini. Taliadoros, despite his injury problems this season, has managed 6 goals. Jones takes up his position on the near post. Catlin tries to ensure that everybody is marked. Salakis. Blair again making his presence felt in the penalty area. Once this season, Steve Blair, that was in a 7-3 victory over Wollongong Macedonia, but now he's got to do some defending as Marconi trying to break quickly. And here's Markovsky chipping that one forward. It's over hit. Playing into the path of David Seal. of course, have had to reorganise their lineup tonight in the absence of David Lowe. It all breaks down for South Melbourne, and now Marconi can break. Gray, forward for Markowski. Still Markowski, got past two, but he couldn't get away from Jurakovic. And here's Taliadoras, as play switches from end to end. Trimboni waits inside the six-yard box, Trimboni against the post! And away in the end by Ocon. Paul Trimboli there has been penalised for offside. Kim Taliadoras attacked quickly after Marconi's attack itself had been broken down. Played it to the near post. And Trimboli's shot there thumps against the woodwork. Good switch in play. There's space on that far side. Ocon. Mark Jones has made the overlap, but Ocon comes inside. Still Ocon trying the shot, it takes a deflection and scores! Bobby Catlin can celebrate this time. And McLaren is beaten. Well, Paul Ocon is acting as if he scored it, but I think he'll be the first to agree it took a deflection. A good run though from the young Socceroos skipper. And the shot comes in and it comes off as a South Melbourne player. And goes past the keeper. It was a goal that was made by Ocon. He started the move inside his own half. He got away from South Melbourne players. And the deflection took it past the keeper. And then 63 minutes gone. And the home side take the lead. And Paul Ocon, if he claims it, it will be his second goal of the season. His only other one, ironically, was also against South Melbourne when they met in Melbourne earlier this year. Free kick now to South Melbourne. You've got a five-man wall. Ian Gray waiting to charge down the kick as well. Referee trying to ensure the wall gets back the required 10 paces. Bobby Catlin in trying to ensure that he's got a good view of it. Here's Peterson, just lifting this one forward. And the header and the equaliser. Angelo Postecoglou gets it past Bobby Catlin, who only seconds earlier was celebrating the goal at the other end. Mickey Peterson chips this free kick to the far post. And Angelo Postecoglou back in the team this week after missing two matches through suspension. Scores his second goal of the season. In 64 minutes, Postecoglou brings South Melbourne back on level terms. It's 2-2 here at Marconi Stadium. Two goals in the space of 60 seconds. I'm sure we've got the crowd here at the Marconi Stadium buzzing. Now Wade. For Trimboli, it was cut out by Wheatley. Now Wheatley. Good switch in play. Jean-Paul Demarini's got space. Time to measure his cross, keeper comes, takes it safely. Salakis. Two options and one of them is Kim Taliadoras. Here's Taliadoras faced by the keeper. And Taliadoras scores. Marconi supporters are silent. Kim Taliadoras, the switch in play from right. And Salakis had two options, and he took the right one. And Taliadoras, good finishing. The keeper, completely stranded. But Palacides had made the run on this near touchline. He'd taken a player with him. that gave the space for Taliadoros. And 68 minutes gone. Marconi Fairfield 2, South Melbourne 3. And for Kim Taliadoros, goal number 7 of the season. Mustacoglu playing it over the defenders. Bowley, their time is run to perfection, faced by Jones. Salakis, Palacides. Wheatley lets it go out of play. And then the referee gives a corner. Robbie Wheatley there, I think, got a shout to let the ball go out of play. Marconi have got to face this corner. Again, in Steve Blair, the big number 5 has gone forward. Trimboli on the near post. Salakis comes off the head of McCulloch. Now Wade, climbed well, couldn't get his header on target. The seal, beaten for the ball again by Durakovic. Palacides. Palacides there trying to pick out Taliadoros. Determination there from Kim Taliadoros has won another corner. South Melbourne at the moment seem hungrier to take the 2 points. Mark Jones, who comes originally from Newcastle, such a competitor. Don't want to look at that scoreline that sees his side training by 3-2. He looks up to the scoreboard just to confirm the fact. There by Aldrin. Peterson. Delightful ball that to Salakis, who whips it across first time. Way by Aldrin. Palacides. Trimboli. Salakis got in there first and found Trimboli. Tries to cut it back. Away again by Aldrin. Here's Salakis. Blocked again by Steve Caldwell. That all started with a magnificent ball from Mickey Peterson. Follis. Wade got in there first. It falls again for Catholis. Defensive work that time by Postecoglou. And now Peterson. Far side. And Marconi wanted to make a substitution. Our youth international, Steve Corica. Now to cut inside. Here's Markowski onto the favourite left foot. And a brilliant save from the keeper. McLaren there, annoyed with Paul Wade, I think, who blocked his view, but he still reacted so well. They've gone on to Markowski's favourite left foot. You can see there, Paul Wade standing in front of the keeper. He would have seen it late. He did so well to push it round for a corner. Here's Gray. Right behind Ocon, the momentum has been lost. South Melbourne now getting players back behind the ball. Wade throwing himself in yet again to another challenge. 5 minutes now of stoppage time. Blair with the clearance. Helped on its way there by Peterson. As the final whistle goes, a victory for South Melbourne. And the form of Marconi here against South Melbourne, they haven't won since 1979. They've gone down here tonight, 1-1 at half-time. Paul Ocon gave Marconi the lead in the second half. But goals from Angelo Postecoglou and Kim Taliadoros settled the issue. The final scoreline here at the Marconi Stadium, Marconi Fairfield. Sheffield 2, South Melbourne.